matter what, I know he's got my back. And
yeah, we're always trying to be there for each other. We were so competitive in anything we did. If we weren't battling each other every day, we probably wouldn't be even close to as good as we are.
You guys are going too hard. Guys, you guys are going to get hurt right now.
What's going on, guys? The Ruotolo bros here. I'm Ty.
Kade. We're going to be showing you guys a day in the life.
So come check it out. It should be real exciting.
Welcome to the Roots Garage. So it's been our lair for the last 4, 5, 6 years.
You know, a lot of magic happens on these mats. A lot of injuries. Yeah.
Blood, sweat, and tears, that's for sure.
For sure.
We grew up in that house. I think when we were 10 years old is when we moved into it. There's been so many different memories and crazy different. We've won a lot in that house. We've lost a lot. We've fought a lot. We've loved a lot. Definitely a bit of history for sure. We got a couple action shots from previous competitions.
That was a cool day. We both took out the Who's Number One Championship together.
It's up here on the roof. You guys see like all the different belts from our childhood, just competing throughout the years. Some of them are even my sisters, I think.
How adorable. So when we won this, we were just frothing. We couldn't believe that. This is when we knew we wanted to do jiu-jitsu for the rest of our lives.
The latest edition, the real one.
It's too heavy to go on the rafters. When we were that age competing, we were competing every weekend. We
started all of our sports at the same time, like 3.5 years old, all before we can remember. It all comes from my dad. So we're basically like mirror images of our dad, I'd say.
I'm so grateful for all these years of competition growing up, you know, because it's
just building that tough mentality at a young age.
I love waking up early.
It's mandatory to go in the sun first thing in the morning.
I'd say we're creatures of habit, so whatever we're usually doing, we're kind of we're on that same track.
It's nice to have a twin brother to, you know, usually have someone to stretch with. You know,
we like to do a lot of stretches that unlock our hips.
I can definitely get when people say, start stretching now, because when you're older, you're gonna get tight and sore and stiff. Because I'm still 20, but I feel tight and sore and stiff, you know? It's
like, kind of get warm for the rap that follows.
What's good, dog? What are you doing?
Sit. I was just wanting to start some scramble, you know, see what he was gonna do.
I thought he was gonna hop on my back, not kick me up in the air and slam me. It was a good move on his part for sure.
Definitely. I already knew exactly what he was thinking. He's thinking, I'm gonna give him my back. He's gonna try and jump on my back. I'm gonna front roll, start a scramble. I didn't want to give him the opportunity. Top. Overall, it was a great morning, pretty mellow, you know, minus the round we had.
Guys, stop!
Oh, all right.
That's good.
That's good, all right.
The slight rolls, guys, you guys are gonna get hurt right now.
I'm fine, Ward.
Manager started to get into it.
I think it's a little dramatic.
That was a little extra.
Honestly, like, that's a normal scrap for us. Like, that happens like once a week, twice a week. You know, we're just basically slapping the crap out of each other. And, yeah, just trying to get each other emotional.
What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Joining me now is a gentleman who has a very exciting, well, I should say grappling super fight. This, of course, will be at One Fight Night 10, Johnson versus Moraes 3. This will be Cinco de Mayo in the United States at the First Bank Arena. Hi, Ty. How are you?
Doing great, brother. Super stoked to be here. Super stoked to get on the card, man. I can't wait. I'm counting the days.
I never really enjoy having a camera in front of my face, to be honest with you. It's not something I look for in my day-to-day, you know? But when it's there, I try to do my best. And yeah, it's getting easier and easier.
Now, you're taking on Reinier de Ridder. He is a black belt in jiu-jitsu. He's obviously a game competitor. What do you think you are up against when you take on Reinier de Ridder?
I'm excited to put my size against his. I'm going to have a lot of looks that he's not used to seeing. You know, I'm very experienced in jiu-jitsu. I've been doing it my whole life. You know, and I think I can definitely make him very uncomfortable in a lot of positions. You know, I like to kind of have that underdog. What's it kind of called?
He's like, no, that's not it. I'm like, it's guaranteed underdog.
I'm really excited to fight, you know, Cinco de Mayo, Colorado, the first U.S. card for one. I'm super honored to be on the card, and I'm ready to go.
I don't know how you forget the word underdog.
That's how rattled my mind was.
You did have 7 cameras on you guys.
But no, other than that, he did pretty good. During the morning time, we like to start off with like a surf or a skate. It helps take my mind off everything else in my life, or as far as competitions, training, things like that. any priorities, interviews, things like that. I can kind of just focus on, you know, surfing when the next wave's gonna come, or skating, you know, my next trick. So I think it's a really cool tool to kind of just keep our mind off our everyday priorities.
Here we are at the Ruka gym. This is pretty much second home to us. We grew up training here. Ruka's been sponsoring us ever since we were 10 years old. Real life playground for us, you know? So a lot of scraps go down in here for sure. This is definitely one of my favorite ones. I think this is the longest belt we stayed at.
It's, yeah, it's been like 15 years of competing, you know? Now it's 17. Like, it was 15 years that took them to get their black belt. And then,
it's like each belt's a couple of years. It's just 2 years. This is another two or three years.
No, this is like a year and a half.
Oh, yeah.
This exactly. was the oldest belt, 3 years.
She knows it all better than we do, honestly.
All those memories are so merged in my brain. So, like, I have memories, but I just don't remember what belt I was exactly. Yeah. You know what I mean? So,
you know, the blue belt meant a lot, I remember, for me, too. It's finally like, it's like your first adult belt.
That meant a lot because that was our first time traveling alone without our parents to compete, you know, like overseas. I'm so grateful for Mama Bear and my dad, of course, and my little sis. They've all been supporting my brother and I as far as jiu-jitsu career goes, you know, from the very first step on the mats till now, you know, nonstop, you know. Kind of have all one goal as the family, you know, so it's no chance we could have made it as far as we have without them. Somehow, some way, Mom got good at social media. I'll give her that. She helps us a lot, so. Yeah. Definitely huge thanks to her on that end of things, because it definitely gets overwhelming sometimes. Let's wait till that hits 35 and we'll do a 5 minute round.
Ready.
Yeah?
Cool.
I know for sure when I step on those mats, no one's mentally gonna be tougher than me. No one's gonna slap my face and scare me, you know what I mean? And that's why we do it in the training, because there's some guys, you step on the mat, next thing you know, you're getting like a hand in the face, a hand in the throat, they're slapping you around, and some guys kind of get intimidated by that, you know? So by us kind of running through those motions every single day in the gym, like, that happens to us, it fires us up. It's like, okay, we can play it that way, you know? So.
You didn't hear the buzzer? Time or Tye?
Well, it was time.
Me versus Tye. Who would win?
It'd be a really tough, crazy match, I'm sure.
I'd probably get him in a footlock.
If he was gonna get me. But you can see the way you said that. I could probably get him in a footlock. I think I could catch Kade in a Darce. I think I could, I mean, it'd be hard, but we do get each other in Darce sometimes. I think I'd win, he thinks he'd win.
You know, while we're in the cage, might as well go over that one, that wall jump that I hit on Shinya Aoki.
Oh, look at that. He jumped off the wall to take the back of Shinya.
We're right here next to the pillar here. So it was kind of hard to get him down. I got that one ankle pick early, but other than that, it was kind of difficult to get him back down. So I remember just glancing to my right and seeing the wall there. And I'm like, you know what? And I just went post as high as I could onto the wall and just jumped as hard as I could while doing like a throw by with my hand. So luckily I went straight to the back over here. And then continued to the back. Doing more acrobatics, as you guys can tell. So maybe some more flying stuff coming soon.
After that gi round, we also mixed it up with some striking.
Funny, because it's like whenever we're boxing other people, feel like our technique's kind of there. Whenever we're hitting mitts, our technique's kind of there. But whenever we go with each other, all technique just goes out the window. Pure emotion.
Great, you know, I love it. It's a little bit newer to the mix. You know, we have huge MMA aspirations this year, so just gotta keep sharpening the tools.
Heading into the sauna, man. I love this sauna. There's so many good health benefits. For me, I use it mainly because my diet's not always the best. I love sugar, you know, so it helps to detox all the toxins I put in for sure. Good little sauna sesh. Already dry after that one. Didn't sweat too much, but ready to go get some food. You hungry?
Guaranteed.
Starving. We need all day.
Yeah, I haven't had a real meal all day, so let's go grind.
It's been a long one so far, you know. There's been so many ups and downs, and the fact that he's been there for all of it, it means a lot, you know.
Overall, good day, a lot of training. Should probably definitely stretch tonight before we get on a flight early in the morning, to be honest with you.
That's usually how it goes. We always go out and support each other no matter what. Sometimes I have to go fight and then go coach him right after, you know, and the vice versa for him.
I remember you were coaching my match in the UK. I had a match, and then literally straight after my match ended, Tye had to get out the coach's seat and he had his match next. So yeah, we're always trying to be there for each other, no matter what.
No matter what, I know he's got my back, and there's no one else I'd rather be on this journey with, you know?